right, how about some post-calibration tests? Well, out comes the kids, so I basically made the test a little short. One thing I did see that was kind of weird and not usual was, as it was landing, it didn't spin in a circle or anything like that, so that's good. But it was almost landing as if there was no sensor on the bottom, because usually, for those who know, when you're landing things like the Mavic Pro, as you're going down and it sees the flat surface, you'll have to hold down for a little while as it determines whether or not it's safe. Whereas this time, when it's landing, it just went at full speed as if you have like the sensors turned off, so you actually have to go down really slow, like don't rely on any of the sensors or anything like that. I did check the settings too, and it seemed like the sensors are on for the bottom, but maybe that is, like I said before, it would make sense if that is the issue at the moment, so I'll just do another test again to see if that's the case. Oh no, it's going nuts again. Okay, for the heck of it, as a test, I'm actually going to turn off the bottom sensors just to see if that actually helps or not. Okay, just did the test again, this time with the vision sensor off on the bottom. It flew well for the most part. I went up and down quite a few times just to see if the same thing would happen. It didn't spin at all, so I'll still need to test it, obviously. Although it did have that little gimbal twitch problem, like at just one point of it, so maybe there is something up with that. It actually makes it kind of unfun, honestly, to fly the drone when you're so concerned like whether or not it's working or not in that case. I guess one of the biggest news actually happened yesterday, but people are still trying to find out what's going on. It has to do with that Notre Dame Cathedral catching on fire, huh? According to all the reports I read too, they're saying this is probably an accident. It says, French President Emmanuel Macron has promised to rebuild fire-ravaged Notre Dame Cathedral and says he is seeking international help to restore the Paris landmark. Notre Dame is burning and I know the sadness and this tremor felt by so many French people. But tonight, I'd like to speak of hope too, he said, announcing the launch of a fundraising campaign. So that's a positive aspect of it. Usually when something really bad happens like this, then everyone around the world gets together to chip in, right? And he says here, let's be proud because we built this cathedral more than 800 years ago. We built it and throughout the centuries let it grow and improved it. So I solemnly say tonight, we will rebuild it together. Must be a drone hardware week this week too, huh? I read again today about another one. This is crowdfunded though, not by a big company to my understanding anyways. It says the world's first all-terrain drone. The X-Tankcopter may just be the ultimate toy for all of us big kids. As the name would suggest, this device is more than just a drone. It's the highly capable combination of both a drone and a tank. So essentially, you ride it in the ground, or if you wish, you could fly it afterwards, and there is a camera built into it. Although by the sounds of it, this isn't meant for capturing cinematic footage. It's more for fun, like just to fly it, just to roll it around, I guess, the gravel area, or even here maybe in the forest and so forth. For the camera, it says it's 1280 by 720 at 30 FPS. Has live video with the remote controller, obviously, and in basically advertising, it works with VR goggles as well. You can even see from their videos, they're kind of advertising this as something to use in various situations to go through tight spaces, mostly for fun, as I would say. And let's look at the weight. The weight, according to this thing, is 123 grams, so hey, you can use this anywhere. As for the price itself, according to this, you can get it for about $99 if you actually go through their crowdfunding site and everything like that. Is there anyone who would actually buy this just for the sake of, I guess, riding it on the ground and flying it for the heck of it? I think for myself, if I wanted something that's multi-purpose in that way, I'd rather have something that goes in the water and then in the air. I know there's stuff like that in existence already, although if they're way too bulky for the most part, or those small ones, apparently the camera isn't that great. So at the moment, I consider it more as a toy in terms of the options. our traffic back up. Oh, the light is gone. Oh, what a long day. See you guys later.